So in the last few classes, we were discussing about the MOS amplifier with a common source kind of configuration. And in fact, in the last class, I have discussed about the different types of load. For example, the diode connected load. Then we have also considered the current source load. And more specifically, if I consider a simple common source kind of MOS amplifier, NMOS amplifier, so it looks something like that. So you have a drain resistance RD over here, which is connected to the drain terminal. And the source was considered to be connected to ground. It's a common source configuration, just like your common emitter configuration in bipolar junction transistor. And the VDD supply was from that particular point. And this was your Vin, the input voltage, which was applied, and accordingly, the output was available from the drain terminal. Now, we have already mentioned that in case of MOS amplifier, our basic objective here to operate the device in the saturation region, because in case of saturation region, we find that the mutual conductance GM, the value of GM is large, and here our objective is to convert the corresponding change in the input voltage to an appropriate change in the drain current. So GM is that particular parameter which measures this del ID upon del VGS for the device itself. And in case of saturation region, the value of GM is large. Whenever the value of GM or whenever the input voltage is less than the threshold voltage, we have already calculated the value of GM was zero. And as the overdrive voltage increases, then the GM value increases proportionately with the overdrive voltage. The expression was like mu n C aux W by L into VGS minus VTH. So as the gate to source voltage increases, the corresponding value of mutual conductance also increases. And we have seen that the expression for voltage gain for this type of amplifier is given by GM times RT. If I just consider the magnitude only, so it will be like GM times RT. So one of the challenge in designing this MOS amplifier is that we have to ensure the mutual conductance or transconductance should be constant to some extent. Because otherwise, if I consider the gain, the mod value of gain, the mod value was like GM times RD. Now, for a particular RD, if RD is fixed, the drain resistance is fixed, and then if the value of mutual conductance is not constant, if it varies with respect to the input voltage, then you'll find that the gain is not constant. So we will find a situation which is known as the nonlinearity of the gain. And we know that in case of the MOS operating in the saturation region, the drain current varies proportionately with respect to the square of the overdrive voltage. So we know the expression for ID in saturation region. So ID was proportional to this VGS minus VTH whole square. So it gives rise to another nonlinearity in case of the MOS transistor operating in the saturation region. So in order to get rid of that, slight modification in this particular architecture was configured. And what people have done is people have inserted one source resistance in series with the source terminal, just like your common emitter amplifier with an emitter resistance connected in series with the emitter terminal. And that particular configuration is known as the common source stage with source degeneration. So let me go to the next slide and let me draw the basic architecture of a common source amplifier with the source degeneration. The name degeneration satisfies that if I consider the term degeneration, that means there is certain degradation. So what kind of degradation is obtained over here, we will understand as soon as we go on investigating the particular device model and the particular circuit in detail. So obviously there will be certain degradation. Now, let me just very quickly draw the circuit diagram. So the same circuit which we have already discussed. the only change is here. We have a source resistance connected in series. So this one is RD, this one is VDD. We have Vout over here, that is output voltage. And there is a source resistance RS, and the input voltage is applied at this particular point. So what happens whenever the current ID, the drain to source current, which is flowing in this particular way. So whenever the value of ID increases because of the increase in the gate to source voltage, because we know that in case of the device operating in the saturation region, the drain current is proportional to the gate to source voltage, the square of gate to source voltage. So if the gate to source voltage increases by a factor of 2, then the corresponding drain current will increase by a factor of 4. Now, whenever the drain current increases in this particular circuit, then obviously what happens? The voltage drop across this resistance, across the source resistance, will also increase. And as a matter of fact, the overall effective gate to source voltage will be to some extent linearized, because the gate to source voltage here is nothing but the difference between this potential minus this potential. So this potential is the gate potential, is nothing but the input voltage, and the source potential is nothing but the voltage drop across the source resistance RS. Now, if the drain current ID increases because of the increase in the input voltage, then obviously there will be the certain increase across this potential, across this RS, the corresponding voltage will be enhanced. And as a matter of fact, the effective value of the gate to source voltage cannot be increased to certain extent. And we can say that this particular arrangement will soften the corresponding nonlinear characteristics of the ID versus VGS minus VTA. Now, to understand this phenomenon in a much better way, let us go into the mathematical part. So we understand that Vout, that is output voltage, can be written like VDD minus ID into RD. So that is the expression for the output voltage. And if I want to calculate the gain expression from this equation, then we have to find out this del Vout upon del Vin, which is nothing but the change in the output voltage for the proportional change in the input voltage. So that can be written as minus del ID upon del Vin into RT, because VDD is constant. So the expression for the gain, that is del Vout by del Vin, can be written like minus del ID by del Vin into RT. Now, this particular thing, del ID by del Vin, is nothing but the mutual conductance of the circuit. It is not the mutual conductance of the device, because for the device, the mutual conductance GM is given by the small gm if I consider, which is nothing but the mutual conductance of the device. So that particular expression is given by del ID upon del VGS, the gate to source voltage. And whereas this del ID upon del Vin, if I consider that this particular circuit, the current that is flowing is ID, the output current that is flowing is ID, and the input that is applied, that is equal to Vin. So del ID by del Vin is nothing but the mutual conductance of the circuit itself. So this mutual conductance can be represented like this del ID by del Vin as a chain rule. It can be represented like del ID upon del VGS into del VGS by del Vin. And you have to identify the relationship between the VGS and Vin. So what is the relationship? So we know that if I just observe over here, the gate to source voltage is the difference between this point and this point, the potential difference between these two terminals, gate and the source. So we can write VGS, that is the gate to source voltage, is equal to Vin, that is the gate potential, minus this ID into RS. So ID into RS is the potential drop across the source resistance, that is RS. So from that, we can write that del phi gs upon del phi in is equal to 1 minus del id by del v in into rs. So now this del id by del v in, we have already mentioned this as the transconductance of the circuit itself, so that can be written like capital gm. So this capital gm can be written like, so this del id by del v gs is nothing but the small gm, the device transconductance, multiplied with del vgs into del vin. So del vgs into del vin is nothing but 1 minus, once again you have got this expression del id by del vin, that is nothing but gm, capital gm, times rs. So ultimately what you get is gm into 1 plus gm rs, that is equal to gm or capital gm, that is the transconductance of the circuit, can be written by gm upon 1 plus gm rs. And if I just observe the expression for the gain, del v out by del v in, the expression for the gain says that av, which is nothing but the proportionate change in the output voltage with respect to the corresponding change in input voltage, that can be written like, so this del id by del vin is nothing but the circuit transconductance. So if I call it like gm, so it is nothing but minus gm times rt. So if I put the value over here of capital gm, that is ultimately it is equal to minus gm rt plus 1 plus gm rs. Now let us, after obtaining this particular expression for the mutual conductance of the circuit itself, now let us try to identify the condition for different levels of current. So what we got is device conductance, transconductance is related to the circuit transconductance by means of this equation. Capital GM is given by 1 G, small gm divided by 1 plus gm rs. And the expression for the gain AV, or if I just write down the modulus of that, that is given by GM times RT. So for a particular RD, for a particular drain resistance or load resistance, the expression of gain is essentially a function of GM. So here our objective is to make the function, or is to make this particular variable a weaker function of the gate to source voltage. So if I find that this particular thing, this capital GM, is a weaker function of the input voltage, then obviously we can say that the gain is linearized, and that is the purpose over here of this source degeneration circuit. Now let us try to identify this particular point. So what we got is capital GM, that is equal to small GM divided upon 1 plus GM times RS. Now as you already know that this small GM, which is essentially the mutual conductance of the circuit, mutual conductance of the device, this small GM, and it's a strong function of the input voltage, because you have seen already that this small gm can be represented by mu n C aux W by L into VGS minus VTH. So it's a function of VGS minus VTH, and as VGS minus VTH increases, then obviously the mutual conductance of the device also increases linearly. So that variation we know. So if I just draw the variation of this gm with respect to the input voltage, this small gm with respect to the input voltage. So we know that until and unless input voltage is less than the threshold voltage, it will be zero. The mutual conductance will be zero. And then it increases linearly like this. This is the threshold voltage, VTH. So beyond this point, the corresponding value of GM increases linearly. Now what happens here for this particular capital GM? Now we find that when the input current is small, input current small means this GMRS, this particular thing, mutual conductance multiplied with the source resistance this is much, much less than 1 because Rs is much, much less than 1 upon Gm, because when the current level is small, so obviously the corresponding value of Gm is also small. The mutual conductance is also small. So therefore, 1 upon Gm, that is large with respect to Rs. So Gm Rs, this particular product, is much, much less than 1. So this happens for lower current level. So this happens for lower current level. And for this condition, capital Gm can be approximated as small Gm, because Gm Rs is much, much less than 1. So in the denominator, we can effectively ignore that part, Gm Rs, with respect to 1. So capital Gm is close to small Gm, is approximately equal to small Gm. So it happens in low current level. Now, what happens when the current level increases? Now, when the current level increases, as you understand, when the input voltage is large, so corresponding current value will also increase. And as a matter of fact, the value of Gm will be large. So 1 by Gm will be small. And this Gm Rs product, it will be larger with respect to 1. So at higher current level, higher current level means the value of Gm is large with respect to higher current level, we can say that this Gm Rs, or in other words, we can say that Gm is large at higher current level, or 1 by Gm is small with respect to Rs, and which leads to Gm Rs much, much greater than 1. Now, under this condition, we can once again find out the expression for Gm, the capital Gm. So now this can be approximated by, so Gm by 1 plus Gm Rs. Now at higher current level, it can be approximated to 1 upon Rs, because in the numerator you have Gm, in the denominator this 1 is negligible with respect to Gm Rs for higher current level, and it can be approximated to 1 upon Rs. So that means it becomes constant. So whenever the current level is large, then the mutual conductance of the circuit itself is constant, and that is given by 1 upon Rs. So it doesn't increase with the input voltage. So once again, if I draw the variation of this capital Gm with respect to the V in, we find that. So I think it will be better if I draw it side by side. The variation of small Gm with respect to V in, and the variation of capital Gm with respect to V in. So we have already seen that up to VTH, it will be 0, and beyond VTH, it increases linearly like this. So this is the threshold voltage. And here, what we find is, initially, obviously, it will be 0. When the input voltage is small, or when the current level is small, it will be 0 up to VTH. And then when the input voltage crosses VTH, and at lower current level, this capital Gm and small Gm will be approximately same. And then ultimately, at very high value of the input voltage, or very high value of the output current, it will be saturated to 1 upon Rs. So if I mark this line as 1 upon Rs, suppose this line is for 1 upon Rs, then ultimately it will be like this. So that is a variation of Gm, capital Gm, with respect to Vin. And we have already seen that the expression of gain for the source degeneration circuit is given by capital Gm times Rd. that is equal to gm times rd divided by 1 plus gmrs. If I just put the value of capital gm over here, so it will be capital gm small gm times rd divided by 1 upon gmrs. Now if you compare this expression of gain with respect to the fundamental circuit without having any source resistance, now we have seen that for that particular circuit the gain expression was like only the numerator part was there. That means only you have small gm times rd. Now because of the inclusion of some non-zero rs over here, so because of the inclusion of rs over here, so we have this term, this additional term. Otherwise this can be regarded as the general expression for the voltage gain. And if I don't have the source resistance, then we can simply put rs equal to 0 and ultimately the value of mod fu will be equal to gm times rt. But since we have some non-zero rs over here, so the expression of gain is equal to gm rt divided by 1 plus gm rs. And here comes the notion of degeneration, because we find that the expression for the gain, I mean, the if I consider the magnitude of the gain, so this magnitude has been reduced with respect to the case when we don't have any source resistance. So the gain is reduced at the cost of what? So we are having one advantage. The advantage is that the gain is linearized to some extent, because ultimately we find that this entire thing, this gm by 1 plus gm rs, gets approximated to 1 upon rs for a very high value of input voltage. So it is no longer a function of the input voltage, or it doesn't increase linearly with input voltage. So that is the one advantage we are getting out of that. The gain is linearized. And on the other hand, the one disadvantage that we are getting, that is obtained from this particular circuit, is that the expression of the gain, the value of the gain is reduced. And that is the source of degeneration over here. Now, in this particular arrangement, we have calculated the expression without considering the other second order effects of the MOS device. So we have two different second order effects that you normally consider. One is the channel length modulation, and the second one is the body effect. So in this particular case, we didn't consider none of this, neither the channel length modulation and nor the body effect. Now if I consider them together, and then obviously the expression for the value of this GM, transconductance of the circuit, will get modified. It will no longer be equal to GM upon 1 plus GMRS. But before going into that, let us once again visualize this expression of gain from a different perspective. Now let me very quickly draw the circuit before introducing the effect of, or the impact of the other second order effects. Let us visualize the gain from a different perspective. So this is the circuit we're talking about. We have drain resistance over here. This is the output terminal. And we have a source resistance, and this is the input voltage. So mod AV says that is equal to GM times RD divided by 1 plus GMRS. So if I now divide both the numerator and denominator by GM, then ultimately it is equal to RD upon RS plus 1 by GM. So this is another way of representing the voltage gain. So in the numerator, we have RD. So RD is the resistance looking at the drain terminal. As you know, RD is the resistance looking at the drain terminal. And in the denominator, we have the series combination of two resistance. One is RS, and the second one is 1 upon GM. So RS is the source resistance, and 1 upon GM is the 1 upon the mutual conductance of the device itself. So RS plus 1 upon GM is nothing but the resistance looking at the source terminal. So in the denominator, this entire thing, RS plus 1 by GM, can be regarded as the total resistance seen from the source terminal. And RD, which is there in the numerator, this is nothing but the resistance looking at the drain terminal. So there is another way of observing this voltage gain as a ratio of two resistance. One is in the numerator, you have the resistance looking at the drain terminal, and in the denominator, you have the series combination of two different resistance That is the total resistance looking from the source terminals. Now, if you have some complicated circuit involving more number of MOS devices, then this particular visualization will help you to calculate the voltage gain without going into the mathematical calculation. Now, having understood this point, now let us very quickly move into the case when we'll be considering the second order effect. In fact, as I have already mentioned, we will be discussing two different second order effect. One is the channel length modulation, and the second one is the body effect. Now, let me start with the small signal model for the same circuit. I think it will be better if I draw the small signal circuit from this point itself. So suppose input voltage that we are applying between the gate terminal and the ground is let it be Vin, the input voltage. So this is the gate terminal. And gate and source, they are not electrically connected, but the voltage difference over here is V1, for example. So obviously, we do have a voltage dependent current source in the form of GM times V1, as you know. Now, since we are introducing the second order effects, obviously we have to identify the R0 that is coming because of the channel length modulation, and which is coming in between the drain and the source terminal. And in order to incorporate the body effect, so we have to incorporate body effect over here because the source is not grounded. Remember here, unlike the previous case, here the source is not grounded. Source is connected to the resistance RS. So obviously the VBS, that means the voltage drop between the bulk and the source, the voltage difference between the substrate and the source is VBS, is non-zero over here. So we have to incorporate the effect of body effect. So obviously this another voltage dependent current source we have to incorporate over here in the form of GMV VBS, and the drain is connected to VDD, so I may consider this to be a AC ground. And suppose the current that is flowing is given by Iout through this terminal, and apart from that we have the source resistance RS connected between the source and the ground. So this is the gate terminal, this is the source terminal, this one is the gate terminal. Gate and source, they are not physically electrically connected, so that's why we have we don't have a direct connection over here, but the voltage induced is V1, and we have the input voltage like Vin, and we do have a GM V1 as the voltage dependent current source. We have R0 to identify the effect of channel length modulation, and we do have GMV VBS, another voltage dependent current source, to identify the impact of body effect, and we have a source resistance over here. Now considering this one, now let us try to identify what is the value of GM, that is the transconductance of the circuit. So first of all, we may write, since the current Iout is flowing through this terminal, so obviously the current Iout will flow through this RS, and the voltage developed across this resistance RS is given by Iout times RS. So the input voltage Vin can be written like this V1 plus the voltage drop across this RS. So that is equal to Iout times RS. And if I apply the KCL at this particular node, then we may write I out, that is the current leaving this node, can be written like GM times V1 plus GMB times VBS. And if I consider the current that is flowing through R0, so that current can be written like Iout RS upon R0. because I out RS is the voltage drop across this terminal. So if I consider the voltage drop between this point and this point, that is the same between this and that. So now if I put the value of V1 over here in terms of V in, because ultimately we have to find out the relationship between the I out and V in. So I have to substitute V in whenever we find V1. So I out can be written like, we have GM over here, and V1 can be written like V in minus I out times RS. Plus we have GMB to VBS. So VBS is nothing but the difference between the bulk and the source. So bulk or body is connected to ground. So VBS is nothing but minus VS. So that can be written like GMB into minus I out times RS. And minus we have minus I out RS by R naught. So I have to take all the I out in one side. So I out into, we have 1 plus GM times RS plus GMB times RS plus RS upon R naught, that is equal to GM times Vin. So I out can be written like GM Vin R naught divided by RS plus 1 plus GM plus GMB into RS multiplied with R naught. So from that we can easily find out the expression for GM, that is the mutual conductance of the circuit, and that is given by I out upon V in. And this gives rise to GM R naught divided by RS plus 1 plus GM plus GMB into RS and whole multiplied with R naught. So last time we have considered the, we did not consider the effect of channel length modulation, and we never considered the impact of body effect. So GMB and R naught was not there in the expression, and we have found that the expression for GM was pretty simple, like GM upon 1 plus GM RS. But this time, since we have considered the effect of both the channel length modulation and the body effect, so therefore we have to introduce this R naught and this GMB into our expression. And ultimately, this is the final expression for the mutual conductance of the circuit, and that is given by GM R naught divided by this one. And the overall output, I mean, the gain of the circuit, the voltage gain of the circuit can be easily written like minus GM times RT. So the only change takes place in the form of capital GM because of the inclusion of these two elements, this R naught and GMB VBS. So already we have seen one disadvantage and one advantage out of this common source amplifier with source degeneration. The advantage comes in the form of the gain is linearized. Gain is to some extent, it's not a strong function of the input voltage. We have found that this capital GM is ultimately, for a very large value of the input voltage, this capital GM gets saturated to 1 upon RS. And that is the advantageous part out of this circuit. And the disadvantage that we are paying over here is that the corresponding gain, the expression for the gain is reduced. I mean, the gain is minimized with respect to the previous gain, which we have got without the presence of the source resistance. Apart from these two, let there be another advantage or another disadvantage in the form of the resistance. So now, if I would like to find out the output resistance resulting from this circuit, let us see how this source resistance affects the output resistance, output impedance of the overall amplifier circuit because of the inclusion of the source resistance. Now, for this purpose, once again, we need to draw the small signal model for the circuit. And while calculating the output resistance, you have to remember that the input voltage should be grounded. There should not be an input voltage. And from the output side, we have to supply on any arbitrary voltage like Vx. And we have to find out what is the current being drawn by the circuit, that is Ix. And we have to find out the ratio between Vx and Ix. So that is the normal procedure to calculate the output resistance of any circuit. And you have also seen the similar type of calculation for a BJT amplifier. Now, the same analogy is also applicable over here. So we don't have any explicit input voltage, so it is grounded. I think I should change the direction. So this is the gate terminal. And suppose gate to source potential drop is, let this difference, let it be V1. And we do have GM times V1 over here in the form of voltage dependent current source. We have to add R0 to identify the effect of channel length modulation. And GMVVS. It is another source, the current source. And we have RS over here, the source resistance that was connected between the source and the ground. This is RS. And let us assume that we have connected some externally applied signal. So let there be this voltage source, which is externally connected between the output terminal of the circuit itself. And suppose this voltage is Vx, and the current being drawn, suppose let this be Ix. And we know that the output resistance R out can simply be calculated by Vx upon Ix. So that is the normal procedure. So now we have to identify. So this Vx should be connected, between this terminal and the ground terminal. Now we have to find out what is the relation between Vx and Ix. Now, if the current Ix flows through this terminal, then obviously the same amount of current will be flowing through the source resistance, that is Rs. And if I consider the voltage drop across Rs, so that is nothing but Ix times Rs. And V1, if I consider that this particular point is, let this point be represented by point S. So if I consider this potential as Vs, so Vs is equal to minus V1. And what about Vs? Vs is equal to Ix times Rs. So we can write V1 that is equal to minus Ix times Rs. And what about VBS? VBS is nothing but VB minus Vs. So this is nothing but the difference between the potential at the bulk and the potential at the source. So VB minus Vs, so that is nothing but minus Vs. And minus Vs means V1. Then what about the current that is flowing through this R naught? We have to identify what is the current that is flowing through R naught, because that current multiplied with R naught plus Ix times Rs will give you the Vx. So ultimately, we can write down the expression for Vx as the voltage drop across R naught plus the voltage drop across this Rs. So that is nothing but if I consider the current through R naught, that is I R naught into R naught plus Ix into Rs, that is equal to V of X. Then what about I R naught? So I R naught can be written like total current is Ix minus GMV1 minus GMV V1, because GB is equal to V1, already we have established. So this is Ix minus GM plus GMV into V1. So that is the expression for the current that is flowing through the resistance R naught. So now if I put this value over here, so R naught multiplied with this current, that is Ix minus GM plus GMV into V1, and already we have seen that V1 is equal to minus Ix Rs. So it will be plus Ix plus GM plus GMB into Ix Rs plus we have this component like Ix Rs. So now we can take this R out. We can easily calculate R out by taking Vx by Rx, this ratio. So Vx upon Ix, so we do have Ix over here, so we can take it outside. So ultimately it will be like, we have this term as R naught plus we have GM plus GMB into RS into R naught plus RS. So that can be simplified like R naught plus one plus GM plus GMB into R naught multiplied with Rs. So if I just forget about this R naught term, then this R out value is can be approximated to 1 plus GM plus GMB times R naught into Rs. Because that particular thing, this 1 plus GM plus GMB into R naught into Rs, is much, much larger with respect to R naught. So ultimately that can be approximated, this R out expression can be approximated to, because that can be neglected with respect to this factor. So this can be written like 1 plus GM plus GMB into R naught multiplied with Rs. So what we find over here is that if we don't have the source resistance, in that case we do have the output resistance is given by R naught. But because of the presence of the source resistance, what we find, this entire thing has been multiplied this output resistance has been multiplied by this interfactor. So we do have 1 plus gm plus gmb into R0 whole multiplied with Rs. And that is because of the presence of this source resistance Rs. So similarly, from this particular expression, we can go back to the previous circuit where Rs was absent. So if Rs was absent, from this particular expression, we can easily find out the expression for Rout. So Rout will be equal to simple R0. That is the output resistance because of the presence of this channel length modulation. So without the presence of Rs, the value of Rout is simple R0. But here, whenever Rs is present, the value of Rout has been enhanced to R0 plus this particular factor. And sometimes this factor is much, much larger as compared to R0. So what we can find is, if the effective output resistance be represented by 1 plus Gm times R0 into Rs, that means there has been a gain by a factor of Gm plus Gmb times Rs. Once again, we may neglect one with respect to this Gm plus Gmb R0. So in that case, the output impedance, previously it was simple R0 if I don't have any Rs or source resistance. Now, if I have the source resistance for this source degeneration circuit of a common source amplifier, MOS amplifier, then the output resistance Rout is given by 1 plus Gm times R0 into Rs. That means there has been an enhancement of the output resistance by a factor of almost equal to Gm plus Gmb times Rs, approximately. So output resistance increases significantly because of the presence of this source resistance. So obviously we find several advantages and disadvantages associated with this source degeneration circuit. But still, we have to do the final calculation. That is the expression for the voltage gain considering all these factors together. That means for a particular finite load resistance RD, and also considering the effect of the channel length modulation and the impact of the body effect. So we have to consider all this second order effect, and ultimately we need to find out the final expression for the voltage gain. So it will be better if I start from the small signal model itself. So we have the input voltage. That is the gate terminal. And the difference is V1, the gate to source voltage drop. We have Gm times V1. This is R0. We identify the effect of channel length modulation. And we do have Gmb times VBS. And for a finite load resistance, that is RD, which is connected between the drain and the VDD, so that can be regarded to be connected between the drain and the ground, because VDD is at AC ground. So this is RD, and this potential, this point is the drain terminal, so this is the V out terminal, and we do have the source resistance connected between the source and the ground terminal. Now under this condition, we have to find out the overall expression for the voltage gain. Now, since it is V out, since the potential over here is V out, so obviously the current that will be flowing across RD or through RD, that is equal to V out by RD, V out upon RD. The direction of the current is from this terminal to this terminal. Now, what about the current that is flowing from this terminal towards this point? That is nothing but the minus of that. If I assume that the plus V out by RD is flowing through this terminal, so minus V out by RD will be flowing through this terminal, and this current will be flowing through the source resistance, that is Rs. So the current through the source resistance, that is Rs, is given by minus V out by RT. Then what about the source potential over here? If I assume that this point is at S, So the source potential Vs can be written like the current that is minus V out by RD, and this current multiplied with the resistance RS will give you the source potential, that is V of S. And we know that V in, that is the input voltage over here. A simple KVL says that V in is equal to V1 plus Vs. Or in other words, we can say that V1 is equal to V in minus Vs, that is equal to V in plus V out by RD into RS. And what about the current that is flowing through R0? Because once again, we have to follow the same logic that V out is given by the voltage drop across R0 plus the voltage drop across this RS. And what is the current that is flowing through R0? That is IR0. So this IR0 can be written like, we have the total current like minus V out by RD. And from that, we have to subtract the current because of these two current source, that is GMV1 plus GMV VBS. So that is nothing but minus V out upon RD minus GM. Now, instead of writing V1, we can represent V1 in terms of this expression, V in and V out. So this will give us V in plus V out by RD into RS. Plus we have GMB, VBS. Now once again, VBS is nothing but VB minus VS. So that is equal to minus VS. So minus VS will give you V out by RD into RS. So GMB multiplied with V out by RD multiplied with RS. So that is all about the IR0, that is the current which is flowing through R0 from this point to this point. So therefore, V out, the expression for V out can be written like IR0 multiplied with R0 plus IRS, if I consider, and this IRS multiplied with RS. In fact, already we know this expression, the voltage drop across this point. So already we have got like IR, the expression for IR0. So from that we can write this is nothing but V out by RD into R0 minus GM into V in plus V out by RD into RS plus GMB into V out by RD into RS. This gets multiplied with R0 minus IRS into RS. So that is the nothing but the voltage drop across RS. Current flowing is minus V out by RD multiplied with the resistance, that is RS. So that is the total expression for V out, and which is a function of both V out and V in. And we have to segregate V out and V in from this expression, and ultimately we have to find out the expression for the gain. Now let me go to the next slide and let us try to solve this expression. So I think it will be better if I take, let me write it down once again. what we find is V out that is equal to minus V out R naught by RT minus V out R naught upon RT minus R naught into minus R naught into FGM into V in plus V out RS by RT. V in plus V out into RS upon RT. Then we do have GMB term. GMB P out RS upon RT. Plus GMB P out RS upon RT. And that gets completed. Minus V out by RT into RS. So now V out and then we have 1 plus R naught by RD from this term and then we have minus sign so it will be plus R naught RS by RD. Then we do have another plus sign. I think I have missed the GM part over here. There is a GM. GM R naught RS by RD plus GMB R naught RS upon RD plus RS upon RT that is equal to we do have minus GM R naught V in only. So now we have RD in the denominator. So then that can be multiplied over here. So minus GM R naught RD into V in. And what is left? We are left with RD plus RO plus RS plus GM plus GMB GM plus GMB multiplied with RS R naught. So now we are almost towards the final step, the expression for the voltage gain AV, that is equal to V out upon V in. So that can be written like minus GM times R naught times RD divided by RD plus RS plus RO plus GM plus GMB into RS RO. Now, before I say anything about this expression, let me go to the previous calculation about the calculation of the output resistance. So what we have found over here is that the output resistance of this type of circuit can be represented like it can be approximated to like RS plus GMB times R naught RS. If I just forget about this R naught term, so then it is simply written like GM plus GMB times R naught RS plus RS. So keeping this in mind, what we can do is we can slightly modify this expression for the gain. So it was like GM times R naught times RD, and then we do have the output resistance which we just now calculated, and the expression was like RS plus, one thing, let me go back, RS plus R naught plus GMB times R naught RS. So let me start from RS terms, R naught term itself. So it was like R naught plus RS plus GM plus GMB times RS into R naught. So that was the expression for the output resistance which we just now calculated. Now it was not there, so obviously we have to multiply and divide this expression, like R naught plus RS plus GM plus GMB times RS R naught. And in the denominator, we do have RD plus RS plus R naught plus GM plus GMB times RS R naught. So what we are looking at, we would like to represent this overall voltage gain as a product of two different entity. One entity is the mutual conductance of the circuit itself, and the second entity is the effective output impedance of the circuit. So keeping this in mind, so already we have previously have calculated the expression for the mutual conductance, that was like GM R naught divided by RS plus R naught plus GM plus GMB times RS R naught. We have already calculated this expression for capital GM, and we can easily find out that part. So what we can do is we can write this expression GM times R naught, that is this part and this part. That is RS plus R naught plus GM plus GMB times RS R naught. This is one part, considering this GM R naught from the numerator and this part from the denominator. So it will constitute a particular factor. Now this gets multiplied with, we have RD into this part divided by this entire thing. So we have RD into R naught plus RS plus GM plus GMB times RS R naught. divided by RD plus RS plus R naught plus GM plus GMB times RS R naught. Well, what I can do is I can just interchange these two. The same thing, but it looks nice. RD plus R naught plus RS. So now we have represented the overall voltage gain as a product of two different factors. One is this one, GM times R naught divided by RS plus R naught plus GMB times RS R naught. And in one of our today's calculations, we have established that this particular thing, this GM R naught divided by this entire thing is nothing but this entire thing, GM R naught divided by RS plus R naught by plus GM plus GMB RS R naught. This entire thing is nothing but capital GM. And if I just consider this expression, so this is nothing but, this expression is nothing but the parallel combination of two different resistance. So if I consider two different resistance like R1 and R2 operating in shunt path, so the effective resistance is given by R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So we have one resistance like RD and the second resistance like R0 plus RS plus GM plus GMB times RS R0. In the last calculation, we have shown that this R0 plus RS plus GM plus GMB times RS R0 is nothing but the output resistance of the common source amplifier circuit with source degeneration. We have just now calculated that part. RS plus R0 plus GM plus GMB times RS R0 is the exact value for Rout. So that is one thing. And we have another resistance like the output resistance, RD, the load resistance, which we have considered in this particular case. So this is one resistance. If I consider, if I identify this as R out and this as RD, so this expression is nothing but RD parallel R out. So RD is coming from the externally connected output resistance or drain resistance, and the effective output resistance of the device itself can be represented by R0 plus RS plus GM plus GMB times RS R0. So ultimately, this entire thing, which we have written like this, so this entire thing will give you the effective value of output resistance. So ultimately, what we can see is the overall voltage gain. So this one is effective R out dashed, if I consider, then ultimately the FE, the voltage gain or the mod value of this FE can be represented as GM, that is the mutual conductance of the circuit, multiplied with the effective value of the output resistance, that if I consider R out dashed or R out effective. And while calculating this entire expression, we have taken into account all the impacts, almost all the second order impacts, like we have considered the effect of channel and modulation, so that's why R0 is over there, which gives you the variation of the corresponding drain current because of the change in the drain to source voltage, and that is nothing but the channel and modulation, and which is much more prominent in case of short channel devices, as you know, and the effect of or the impact of the body effect has also been embedded into this equation by virtue of the parameter GM, which is the mutual conductance of this device when the body effect is prominent. So considering GMB and as well as R0, we have ultimately obtained the expression for the voltage gain. Once again, this voltage gain can be written as the product of two different entity, that is like GM times R out dashed or R out effective. And one thing you must appreciate over here is that the value of the voltage gain is much more stable with respect to the previous arrangement that we have already considered. And however, there is a degradation in the value of the gain. And we have seen a similar type of observation while we have studied the bipolar junction transistor. You have seen that if I have a simple collector resistance, the value of the gain is given by minus GM times RC. And once we connect some RE, the emitter resistance, in series with the emitter terminal, then the value of the gain can be reduced like minus RC upon RE. So once again, the gain is stabilized, but at the cost of reduced gain. So that is another arrangement which we have discussed today. And hopefully in the next class, I'll be talking about the other configuration of the MOS amplifier. So we have only considered the common source kind of configuration in last few classes. And then I'd be talking about the common drain kind of configuration, which is a similar one like a common collector in BJT. The counterpart is a common collector, a common drain, and which is also called the source follower, like an emitter follower. And we should also consider the common gate type of configuration. So these configurations will be discussed in the next classes. And with this, let me conclude my today's discussion on common source amplifier with source regeneration.